Energy efficient building, what does it actually mean? I once attended a seminar when one university professor spoke about energy efficiency, and I really did like how he defined the energy efficiency. He said that energy efficient home is a home which is not a burden to the environment and the owner's wallet. We are often asked about energy rating or energy class of our houses. Is it a class A or a class B? It's not actually that simple. It's not just about the shell and the insulation. The energy rating is given to a building by several factors. First is a geographical location. You can imagine that the requirements for insulation and heating are quite different in Florida and in Alaska. So if you have a very efficient heating system, you can spend a little less on the insulation material. And if you just have electricity available or some, I don't know, oil for heating, you really need to spend more on insulation material. If you are lucky enough to find like geothermal water, is hot water coming out of the ground on your property, a tent can be an energy efficient home. But if you are utilizing energy made from fossil fuels, then you really need to have a good insulation to keep every little bit of this expensive mother nature killing energy inside your house. And then you need like passive house technologies and ventilation systems with a heat recovery. My own home, I only have 10 inches of insulation because I have 10 hectares of forest, and there are always some dead trees I can cut down and burn them. So energy efficiency in my house, it's not really about insulation so much. I'm living in the cold climate. We have something like minus 10 or something outside. Often people think about energy efficient home as a very well insulated home. Well, in most cases it's true, but you should think about heating systems and ventilation systems, because most of the heat you actually use through ventilation. If you are changing the air inside of a house, and we do consume air as a living beings, also the plants inside of house and maybe pets, so we need to change the air. And if you take the cold air inside and let the warm air out, you need energy to heat the fresh air up again. So you really need a good insulation, heating system, ventilation system, and the energy rating or energy class is a result or combination of all these. Very important thing about building an energy efficient home is windproofing. If you just put the insulation and you skip the fabric or tiles or whatever you use for windproofing, wind will find its way through the insulation. I did that mistake on my first house, and it was a very warm house in the first 3 years. And then in the places where it wasn't very well sealed from the wind, wind just made its way. So we are using Tyvek fabric, which is very strong, and we use the strongest version because in terms of the total budget, it's a very, very little price increase, but it gives you much, much more security. Avrame homes work really well in the cold winters, you can see. And since insulation works both ways, if it's very hot outside and you have a good insulation, it's like a thermobottle. You can keep hot coffee or ice cream in there. It works both ways. Because insulation should keep the difference in temperature. Like in winter, if you have plus 20 Celsius inside and minus 20 Celsius outside, the difference is 40 degrees. In the summer, it's never 40 degrees. You want plus 20 inside, and if it's outside, plus 35, it's just 15 degrees of difference you need to keep. So they work even better in summer. Modern houses often have a big windows, and if you want a big window, you should consider really high quality triple pane windows. Modern windows are quite energy efficient, but they are still less energy efficient as a wall. So if you want a lot of light in your house and a lot of windows, it means you need to go for a really good windows, otherwise you will lose the heat. Same applies to the doors, but no one really wants many, many doors.